Stanley Cup Final. New Jersey was merciless, dismantling the Cinderella Mighty Ducks with surgical precision. When the battle ended, the Devils had shut out the Ducks twice. They marched into Anaheim to complete their mission. But returning to their Magic Kingdom, the Ducks rediscovered the charmed existence that carried them through their miracle playoff run. The invincible machine was no more. And the script suddenly became the fairy tale ending the Ducks had written so many times before.
Overtime game winner! We've got a touchdown!
But like all great fantasies, the Ducks must now travel a great distance and perform an act of heroism before they can journey home. They cannot be champions until they enter the Devil's lair and rise up and defeat the machine. Sleep in your own bed and play hockey on your own ice.
10-1. Yeah, I think I agree with you. I don't know if he wants to go to overtime, though.
No. Overtime's not been kind to him so far in his career. Score! Right on the faceoff! The Mighty Ducks get it. Paul Correa was back along the point. Sykora got the shot. It is 1-0 Anaheim.
Again, a faceoff. It's going to be the bugaboo that Pat Burns is not going to be able to get off his back.
Again, it's Adam Oates, and Adam Oates is used for offensive zone faceoffs, not defensive zone faceoffs.
See, here's the disadvantage. John Madden tried to power him to the forehand side of the boards, and from the Southwest Airlines goal camp, you'll see the result of forehand power against backhand power. Oates' backhand power, just too much.
That is the first period goal that we have had in this series. And it comes early in the first minute of play. Giguere now goes down behind the play as he got run into. Roll back off Niedermeyer's stick to Rucchin. Rucchin down the middle, left to Niedermeyer. Backhander, save made by Brodeur. The Ducks have already had about four scoring chances here in the opening minute, 7 seconds. Near side to Vizdevsky. Looking, shot, deflected, save, just wide of the net. Niedermeyer was there in the deflection. And right now the Ducks have every step.
We don't have to tell anybody how important a two-goal lead would be. A one-goal lead has been something that neither team could overcome.
Well, Mike Babcock double-shifted the Rucchin line with Correa to get themselves going early, and they are.
Pahlsson almost. Brodeur did not handle that cleanly. Gomez will pick it up. Neither team has lost when scoring first this playoff year. A 1-0 lead for the Ducks. Set back for Gomez. Gomez looking to center. Tied up. Got it off the point. Kicked away. Tavadovsky not very far. Chistov moved it over to Pahlsson. Back to Chistov. Chistov kicking at it. Came back into his skates. Tavadovsky able to get it. Moves it up for Elias to Gomez. And out of the zone.
And one team has legs early. That's the Ducks. And the Devils don't.
But to get that many good scoring chances this early is a sure sign that, you know what, it's as much about the Devils as it is the Mighty Ducks. The Mighty Ducks have legs, but this ain't the Devils, boys.
Six shots in the game for Anaheim already. Down the middle, LeClaire. LeClaire looking. He's going to get another. Put that one through the middle. Ozolinch moving up. Tried to dump it. Ozolinch leaves it down low. LeClaire cutting. Stripped of the puck by Rheaume. Up the far side. The attempted tip out goes nowhere. Ozolinch moving it in. Poke checked away by Pandolfo. The goal at 42 seconds. Sykora's first of this series. Third of the playoffs. And Oates picks up another assist.
And it's still men against boys.
Cleared up the near side by Marshall. Marshall looking in the middle, trying to hit Madden, deflected up and into the seats. In front, bouncing puck. Rafalski got it down low. Breland batted it up in the air, still loose. Rheaume shot, blocked to the corner. Giguere just held his ground. Turner Stevenson shot. Score! The Devils tie it up! Stevenson, it may have been deflected, but it's 1-1.
Well, that's how you put out a fire. Hey, maybe this is the game that's going to be a 6-5 game. They're usually one in a series. Yeah, baby. Turner Stevenson, before he even scored, was wide open there, right there. He was wide open. They couldn't get the puck to him. So he stepped out to the hash marks and kept his play alive.
It's a turnaround blind shot. It may have been deflected past Giguere. Stevenson hasn't played since game 6 of the previous series. And how about that? Rheaume got the the goal. Rheaume deflected it in on Stevenson's turnaround pass. We're tied at one.
You talk about momentum changes. Well, the momentum in this game has changed already. We have played 4 minutes. Knocked away on the shot by Biles. Ends up going into the netting. That'll be whistled. So the Devils respond. Pascal Rheaume, who's not played a lot of minutes in this series, picks up the first goal of the playoffs.
I think the Devils want to establish their bigger players. Rayom's had a couple of shifts. Stevenson, too. And how about this with a team score first in the game? The Oilers in 84 went 11-0 with that great team they had. The Devils 10-0 and the Ducks 10-0.
And the Ducks scored first. To Madden, deflected. LeClaire had it blocked by Madden into the seats.
This shift, whoa, baby. This shift, Madden and Oates were really chopping at each other away from the puck. Two opposite centermen. Madden now gets out of the scrum.
He looks like he's hurt. He's gone to the bench, bent over without his helmet
baby.
On. He's holding, yeah, he may be cut above the eye. John Madden has a towel over his eye. Now he went and got the towel. He's coming back to the pile.
I think he wants to make sure the referee knows that there's been a cut or an injury. Oates now gets up off the ice. And we have some heat here in the first period. Oates looks like he's going to the box.
And Madden is screaming at Bill McCreary, the referee, and Paul Dvorsky.
I think I saw McCreary point to Niedermeyer. I think he's going to go to the box, too. There you go. Oates and Madden, guys, were skating up and down, chopping at each other's ankles behind the puck. And then when the whistle sounded...
Watch this. It was Oates that got Madden right there. Plus check to the cheek. But then, man, did Niedermeyer ever take Adam Oates? Interesting to see what these calls are. What do we got here?
Scott Stevens is not happy about matching roughing calls here. They're back in behind the net. The bump put on Gomez. Moved away Soleil. Soleil couldn't get it up. Third around the near side. Boys for Polsky. Center and shot.
The Devils' power play is not better when they've got Scott Niedermeyer and Brian Rafalski on the blue line. This play by Brian Rafalski keeps me wondering why. Watch when the puck comes around to the point. Elias is the only man in front. Brian Rafalski saw him and put it tape to tape.
Two similar goals for the Devils. Elias had been behind the net, went on around the net to the right side of the goaltender, and nobody on the Ducks saw him there. And Rafalski did. Bullseye pass. The Devils lead for the first time in the game, and Elias has both the Devils' power play goals in this series.
Both Anaheim defensemen were about 6 feet apart in that play. There was a miscue for sure.
A 2-1 lead as the Devils respond with the next two goals after falling behind 1-0. This will be icing. No. Yes. Just crossed the line, and Tommy Haviland back to get it.
What a hit by Friesen on Haviland in the corner. The Devils big forwards, and with Rupp in the lineup, and with Stevenson in the lineup, and big guys like Friesen, you've got a big team for the Devils going in this game. If they get their hitting game going, watch out.
There's a lot of talking going on.
Look at two defensemen, 24 and 34, both right beside each other, Kurt Sauer and Ruslan Soleil. First time in this series that there has been a lead change in a game.
Amazing. Both teams had consecutive win streaks going where they had had a lead at any point in the game. That's going to go by the boards. Niedermeyer, speaking of boards, hit by White into the middle. Brodeur had Oates all alone. Ozilic missed it on the short side. LeClaire behind the net trying to tuck it in. Can't. Blocked by Brodeur. Brodeur lost his stick. Picks it back up. Oates drops it. Down to the front. LeClaire poked away. Friesen. Turned around the boards and out. There was only one D back, and he was on the other side. Nick Hovland. That forced Giguere up to get it over to Ozilic. Ozilic was down in the corner playing forward.
Santos Ozilic, I think, has gone into his riverboat gambler act a little early.
Bill, we were laughing during the warm-ups. Ozilic and the two-on-ones, the defenseman's the one. Ozilic was going with the ball.
You know, if he hit the net there, he might have scored.
No, he was right there.
And he's plus nine in the series, or in the playoffs make it, so... Yeah, he's taking a chance here, but you know what? This game kind of is that way for a change.
I think he stayed down there. That was the issue. And if the pass around the boards had been softer, the Devils had a clean two-on-one. So take your shot, but get back. Yeah.
Good play. Turner Stevenson forces the issue. Giguere wanted to beat his D. Couldn't find him. Rheaume! Glove save by Giguere. Who says these teams live by defense alone? Slow roller. Elias! Another slow roller batted away. To the boards, Pandolfo to Rafalski to Elias, deflected on goal, batted in, no goal, no goal, called
see Dvorsky, the referee, saying, moved in with his right arm and shoulder. That's exactly accurate. The puck was up in the air, and it knocked in with the right arm, directed in with the arm, no goal.
Paul Kariya had no stick here, and Brian Rafalski took advantage of it. A little deflection up to Brian Gionta. Yeah, and he just kept on pushing with it, didn't he?
Yeah, he elbowed the puck right into the net. Nice play, but no goal.
Can't do that.
Hand, maybe, the backhand side of his glove, yeah. Good call by the officials right there. One of the rebounds before that got away from Giguere, and I'm just watching Jiggy in this game so far. He's not real steady handling the puck regarding rebounds.
Kicked away, Giguere again, just barely caught that one up. The New Jersey Devils, there is Scott Stevens, have been constant partners out there on the ice and not dancing partners. Career along the wall, there's Stevens looking for him. Stevens got a shoulder and shot, score! Rucchin ties it! With a line wrinkle. He threw Petr Sykora on the right side of Rucchin and Kariya instead of Robbie Niedermeyer, and it's pay dirt immediately for him.
A real smart dump in by the Mighty Ducks. Kept the puck away from Brodeur. Then they worked Scott Stevens, a two-on-one on him in the corner. Moved the puck in front. Look at this quick wrist shot off the goalpost. Beautiful shot by Rucchin, and we have a shootout. 2-2 here in the first period.
Steve Rucchin's gotten stronger. Rucchin has every game in this series.
Rucchin had not had a point in five games. This series, first four games, 12 total goals. Question now is, will there be 12 goals in game five? Behind the net, loose. Devils trying to get it right back. Game's tied at two. Rough with it. Soleil was on him. Langenbrunner. Langenbrunner turning it. Gets a little pick. Goes on top shot. Friesen saved again. To reach out through a screen with Ruck cutting in front of him. Cleared out of the zone. Niedermeyer chased her down. Lost it. LeClaire looking into the middle. Goes off Niedermeyer's stick to his brother. Bob Niedermeyer in the corner. Back for Adam Oates. Oates trying to center. Hit the back of the net with it. Scout. And guess who's got it? Madden. Missed a shorthanded. In. Madden shot off the blocker. And went up into the netting. And Jay Pandolfo went into the net.
Guys, it seems to me that when the Devils are shorthanded, we all know Madden gets his scoring chances. And I asked him about it. He said when he played college hockey for Michigan, for Red Berenson, and boy, you can
look
see where he got
zipper.
Cut down, down the left
gracious.
Side of his face. But when he played in Michigan, he killed penalties with a guy by the name of Brendan Morrison, who's a great first-line center for the Vancouver Canucks, and that was a save by Giguere. So he said whenever Red Berenson in Michigan needed a goal, they'd be put on the ice shorthanded. They'd go out and score. That was the play, by the way, where Ozelich got him with the stick and he got cut.
I can't believe he did that much damage. We've seen guys get cross-checked look far more flagrant than that. It looked like he...
Oh! Through the crease! It came through the legs of Giguere. Bouncing puck. They're going to wave off Eddie Icing, and we've got a period done, and what a period! Sykora and Rucchin score for the Ducks in between Rheaume and Elias for the Devils.
You know, from a goaltender's point of view, you want to make sure that you don't knock the puck into your own net. Here it comes. Get out of the way. Oh, baby. And then some help from the defenseman in front.
Yeah, you look around immediately to see whose stick is out there. It was Ruslan Soleil, and that is when Giguere just breathed a sigh of relief.
Coming up, our intermission, John Saunders, Barry Melrose, and Chris Berman. They'll get you caught up on Cinderellas of the past. Darren will take a look with his goalie report. That's going to be coming up right now. A tremendous first period as a series where the goals just would not come came here, and it's 2-2. This presentation of the Stanley Cup Finals on ABC will continue after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Intentionally kicked that one away so LeClaire could not get to it. Niedermeyer in. Pandolfo a trailer. A screen. A shot blocked into the corner. Over to get a Gionta looking for Madden in front. Madden! Score! Devils get the lead!
Gary, you called it. Gary, you called it. Brodeur with his rebound control. He knocked the puck with his blocker. Passed all the Ducks around his goal net. And then the Devils came off ice and were able to score. Watch the blocker and the puck. And all the Ducks in deep. Bang! Way out above everybody. Niedermeyer's there. And the Devils going to work.
They were still in good shape until Sandis Ozelich didn't know where the puck went. It went into the corner. Look at how much time Gionta has. Sandis Ozelich stood facing the other way, not knowing what had happened. And Mike LeClaire actually deflected that in by Giguere.
Niedermeyer and Oates are out there in the middle of a line change. Shot!
Pahlsson shot. It's tied again. Sammy Pahlsson 3-3.
Oh, some great play. See Keith Carney's name in there on his back. He came all the way across to the far side of the ice to keep this play alive and to keep the play in the offensive zone.
Good call, Bill. Pahlsson came back to help Carney because Ozilic was in deep. And then Carney went to the near side, kept the play alive, put the puck deep, and there's Pahlsson moving in. Bang!
Underrated pass from Rob Niedermeyer, too, from our Southwest Airlines goal time. Reaction time for Marty Brodeur, limited. He has had pucks just smashed by him, and I don't think you could say that Brodeur was bad on any of them. They were just rockets.
I haven't been out late. In fact, here in the New York area, we haven't seen the sun for 2 months.
Comes it back behind the net. Set up in front is Friesen. Langenbrunner looking. Langenbrunner leaves it. Freeland back to the middle. Tavadovsky. You see how the D moved down for the Ducks. Penalty's over. Freeland redirected. Save made by Giguere just as the penalty expired. One shot off that power play chance. The Devils now 1-for-4.
Well, the Mighty Ducks have been really mistake-free on their penalty kill since the mistake they made that allowed the Devils to score a power play goal. Good coverage, not many shots clean. Giguere hasn't had to be very good on the penalty kill. And very often, he needs to be your best killer.
Pandolfo, he goes wide, looking. Gionta, shot, save, rebound, score!
Immediately.
The first goal was disallowed because the puck was batted in with a part of the body, which is rule 57C. Now, this one appeared to go off the skate. Was it directed in intentionally? In other words, a distinct kicking motion by Pandolfo.
It can rebound. It can be directed in. Boy, that's a tough one. But you could probably make the case that it was because there was a motion with the foot. I think Pandolfo was only stopping, but
I think it's a goal. I think that should be a goal. They're going upstairs now. Bill, that was not a distinct kicking motion. He turned his skate. He turned his skate. That's within the rules.
He didn't push it towards the net. He pushed it towards the net with his skate. But I agree with you that it might not be classified as a distinct kicking motion.
If you think of distinct kicking motion like a person kicking a field goal, right?
Well, that's
a type of an analogy.
We'll see. This is tough. This is the toughest one of these kind I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Now, the other thing, you got to keep the rules, Robert's rules, in mind here. The upstairs, they will not reverse the call made by the official on the ice unless it is clear that the official was wrong.
It's Andy Van Hellemond on the phone, and he's the main official man with the NHL. He's on the phone with Bill McCreary.
It's a goal. The Devils have a 4-3 lead.
What a bizarre game.
Go away.
But here's the other thing. Did anybody notice how much room this puck had to get in? No, about a puck width. That is it. It looked like it nicked the tip of Giguere's skate and then actually went off the post.
That's four goals at the midpoint or near the midpoint of this game, regulation-wise, against Giguere, who just does not seem to be comfortable. Now, Mike Babcock sent Paul Kariya across to say, why? Why'd you allow the goal? He just had it explained to him. He's going back to the bench. Both these goaltenders work hard with their goalie coaches, and I really think that Giguere, in looking at tape probably tomorrow, will realize rebounds. He has had a ton of rebounds get away from him.
Ozilic, and a save made by Brodeur.
It may be the goalie that makes the last good save that ends up winning this one. Right now, the Devils have a one-goal lead. Again, with a face-off in the offensive zone. And again, Adamoge right between his legs. Ozilic still got this shot away because there was so much interference in front. Nobody came to him. If he gets the first go at it, he rips one.
Tries it again. Another save made off an Ozilic chance. Marty Brodeur with two saves. Turner Stevenson in.
Boy, the Devils changed sentiment for the two faceoffs, and Adam Oates beat Rheaume, and then he beat Madden, and shots on goal on both plays.
They're down to only two more sentiment to go. You can bring up, you know, at some point you go through them all and say, any volunteers?
Adam Oates out there, just bring them on. Nice! Trying to get it to Gionta. 5 seconds left to go in the period. Paul Kariya looking for a little room to get a shot off. Can't. And we've completed two. The winner of this game will have a 3-2 lead in the series. the leader after two, the Devils four, and the Ducks three. Coming up, our Dodge Intermission Report, John Saunders, Barry Melrose, and Chris Berman. Take a breath, because it has been that kind of a game. The Devils trying to continue their home magic. They are 10-1 here in their home ice. We'll be back. The Dodge Intermission Report after this message and a word from our ABC stations. After two, it's the Devils four and the Ducks three. Seconds for a 39-year-old and a game winner in a finals for the first time. He's in the finals for the first time. Rough shot, block, Niedermeyer trying to redirect. Langenbrunner scores! Jamie Langenbrunner!
Boy, you gotta like the Devils' approach. They have come out here and not tried to sit on the lead at all, and as a result, now they've got a two-goal lead. Scott Niedermeyer, look at this. He wheeled it through the neutral zone and made it happen. When he dropped the rough, he went right for the net and bounced out in front to Langenbrunner. Hater, baby. Two-goal lead.
Remember, the shots were 6-0 early in favor of the Ducks. 27-13 in favor of New Jersey since. They're just going to the net with everything, guys. They're not being too fancy. It's just to the net, to the net.
Right. Rebound. Picked back up the near side and up by Chistov. Big tie up behind. Ooh, getting nasty behind the play, folks. There's no whistle. They're letting him go, but in the zone, they finally get a whistle. Look at Marshall tied up with Soleil.
He wouldn't let go of Soleil's skate. What a sequence. If the linesman had had a hacksaw, he would have used it to separate them. That was really weird. I don't even want to try to explain it. We'll have to get a look at it. I know I can follow it if there are pictures, but it's way too bizarre.
There was a linesman there. There was a referee standing there watching, and the two of them looked like they were in a ring having a wrestling match. Soleil gave Marshall a pretty good shot when he was down on the ice.
Giguere had his stick caught in Marshall's leg, and then Marshall fell down, turned around to swing at Giguere, and held up. Soleil thought he'd hit him, punched him in the face when he was down. Here we go. Watch Giguere's stick here, right there. Oh, he got caught in Grant Marshall's crotch. What a bad place to get a stick cut. Marshall kind of swatted him. Soleil said, why, I oughta. And the hacksaw never showed up.
Where'd that why I oughta come from?
That's what he was saying. Look at this. Ozil, save, save. Twice. Marty Brodeur. Ozil came out of the clouds. Back in. Madden shot. Blow down by Giguere.
Oh, that's hockey, baby. Brodeur with his biggest save. He's got his team ahead by two. And then the Devils tried to put it away, and Giguere's catching glove was there.
What was that?
That was a breakdown. Look at three Devils along the boards, and the fourth one showed up. Everybody was along the wall. Sandis Ozilinch could have made this a very interesting finish with a goal there. The Devils aren't out of the woods if he scores on this one. From our Southwest Airlines goal cam, we will show you Marty Brodeur's best save of the game.
With a Paul Kariya setup in front to Ozilinch.
There was nobody within half the ice surface of Ozilinch. 7:20 left to go in this game. Knocked away from Niedermeyer into the backhand motion. Langenbrunner, save made by Giguere. Jamie Langenbrunner looking for his second goal. Wanted to feed it in. Got knocked down. He's got it! Langenbrunner scores!
Okay, my question, guys, why not change the goaltender? Because, to me, Giguere's got to fly all the way back to California and play in two nights. Let him rest some.
Jamie Langenbrunner doesn't really care who's in goal right now because he is hot. What a super play by Brian Gionta. Outstretched to make this thing happen. Watch this. This is a dead play if Gionta doesn't look like he's 6'4 instead of 5'4. Okay, Brian, you're taller than that, but not that much.
Brodeur's team up by three goals with 7 minutes to go. I just think, why not give a guy a break? You've got to fly all the way back to California and play in two nights.
I know. Play. Shot on, Brodeur the save on Swedar. 4 seconds left to go. The Devils on home ice, a 6-3 win, lead the series 3-2.
Oh, boy. Sticks up at center ice. Rupp and Niedermeyer. Rupp has dropped his gloves. The linesman and referees do a great job to separate this. Paul Kariya three games here in New Jersey in this series, one shot on goal, and that was in game one. So they've done a great job on the Ducks captain. They now have to find a way to recover, and the Devils are going to go for the kill.
It will also be the first time that the Mighty Ducks in this playoff year will face elimination. It'll be interesting to see how they react in that scenario.
Only the fifth game, Bill, they've lost all year. They're 14-5 this playoff year for the Mighty Ducks. And they, too, have had a great home record. Both of these teams do not lose games on their home ice.
And don't forget game seven.
Yes, that's right.
Monday night. It'll be Monday night back here.
Anaheim is 8-1 at home. They've given up a grand total of 11 goals in 9 games in Anaheim.
When Pat Burns became the head coach of the Devils, he tried to impress upon his team, win on home ice. They weren't that good a season ago, and this season they have been awesome from start to finish, and that has paid off in the playoffs. Now, remember, 4-6 on the road, though.
Yeah. Pandolfo and Langenbrunner, stars number 3 and 2, respectively. And Brian Gionta coming out. Those are your three stars in this game tonight. And for the first time since 78, home teams have won the first 5 games of the Stanley Cup Final.
What's really interesting to me in this game is a lot of guys who had offers for a long time in the playoffs got goals for both teams. And what that means is they're alive and well now. So both teams have more offense to work with, I think, in game 6.
And Lord Stanley's Real Cup's going to be in Anaheim. And so will we and Samantha Ryan. Sam.
Well, guys, Jamie Langenbrunner, 2 of the Devils' 6 goals. Coach told the media yesterday that this team needs to be more excited when you guys get the puck. What did he tell you guys?
Just that. You know, we had a play to win instead of play not to lose. You know, we went to Anaheim there, and we were, you know, on our heels and let them take the play to us. And tonight we wanted to come out and play our game and go at them a little bit.
You played your game in the third period. You went into the period with a 1-goal lead. You had 2 of your goals, both of your goals in the third period. What was the mindset of this team going into the third?
Well, our mindset was to stay at them. You know, we didn't want to sit back on and let them come at us. And I think we did a good job of, you know, staying with the first man forecheck and creating pressure on them. We were able to get a couple.
Now you go to Anaheim. The Stanley Cup will be waiting for you Saturday night. How do you use this confidence to finish the task at hand and not get too cocky?
We're definitely not going to get too cocky. We learned our lesson the hard way the first time. You know, obviously we had 2-0 lead, and they came back. We know this team we're playing is a hard team to play against, and they're going to battle the whole way, and we have to come with our best effort if we expect to win there on Saturday.
Game 6 Saturday night. Jamie Langenbrunner, 2 goals. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Jamie Langenbrunner, thanks, Sam, had had 2 goals in 14 games. Got 2 tonight. And I want to correct myself on something I said earlier. Colorado and New Jersey, the last time the Devils, when they had 2 chances to win, Colorado won game 6 here in New Jersey. Game 7 was in Colorado. I had a flip-flop.
Well, the New Jersey Devils now have gone 11 games, playoff games, in the third period without giving up a third-period goal here at home. That is a new record, playoff record. They did it again here tonight. They've come away with a 6-3 victory. We're coming back. Continental Airlines Arena's the site. The Devils have won game 5.